Hey everyone, Ronald here bringing you another Thursday updates. Now what you see behind me isn't new blocks, they're good old fashioned guys. But they've gotten an upgrade because Space Engineers has gotten a graphics update. That's right, we're at DirectX 11 now. And these lucky guys behind us are the first up to get the new models for DirectX 11. Now what we got is the gyro, the warheads, the projectors, beacon in the back, and spotlights, and the small ship counterparts. So let's go ahead and take a closer look here. Gyroscopes, not much details changed in my opinion, that one, but here, it's a lot more minor details. Over here, there's definitely a difference. Instead of being a plus sign, it looks like crosshairs and pegs. And I mean, there's a lot more minor details in the framework here. As is on the big guy, and the center doesn't look empty anymore like it did originally, which I find much better. It makes more sense. Over here we got spotlights with protective framing on the front, I think. Smaller doesn't have the front, but it's even got its own little quirks for update. Over here, we've got beacon. Kind of reminds me of a lighthouse light right there. And she does light up. I kind of got it turned off, but you can see that one over there is lit up nicely. Warheads. Oh. Jeez, the details in this thing. Got the little rods, these little trip rods. Got these little guys right here. They've got their own little custom bits. The frames out different, the ball's a little smaller. Keypad looks the same. Ooh, there's a logo. Is that right side up or is that upside down? Can't tell, but it looks like it might be an LE. And LE. Let's explode. Yeah. Okay, there's one thing I had to test with this thing. Safety off. Countdown. Stop. Not bad. So everything that's green on here does change. That's kind of cool. So these are new blocks. Now another thing they've updated, and I've got it set up so I can do this. Is this is our update platform right here. What they've done with this is I could go and copy this, and we get the usual snap. If I hit B, we could start doing this with it. Paste it in, and now you can adjust your station to be better with the sun angle.
Oh wow.
I just realized the lighting difference in this place.
Wow. Anyway, I was just saying. Come over here.
And run over here.
Now, we all know that's a station, and this one started moving
like a ship after I pressed B.
If I come into here, under info, you can see the convert to ship button here that I got flashing is actually functional, which means this is a station still. 100% station. Yet we're able to angle it however we want. No more snap grid annoyance. We can have whatever angle, which means rotors go out the window, because we can put our stations in the angle of the best use the solar panels. Woohoo! Now let's see. Code. So yeah, DirectX 11. Okay, it looks like they also fixed clients dying for no apparent reason. I've seen a lot of that on Sage's, Ecto Sage's videos of the Let's Plays. Fix setting Ragdoll World Matrix. So apparently fix the ragdolls. And fix the character shaking. Also they put out a video to help modders move into DirectX 11. If you don't already know how. So I'll leave a link in that. I'll leave a link in the description for the fixes page like I always do, and you'll find the video there. So let's see. Wow, the lighting system in this new setup is even different. But as you can see, a lot of the old blocks are still unchanged. Whoa. Grass acts different. Just slightly. Okay, hang on. Which window was that again? It was one of these big 3x3s. Wait a second. Is me okay? Huh, another thing I got updated sneaky like. Tintings got updated where you actually can see through the windows from both sides. Well, clearly, just one side's a little darker than the other. Before, you couldn't even see in, but you could see out. So, there's a change for you. Some sneaks. Let's see. I don't see anything else that's been changed. This is one of my drones that's been doing the routes. Yeah, you guys remember those from last episode. Let's see. Those haven't got new models, so those won't show anything new. Yeah, it looks like they updated the windows with very sneaky-like. Oh, another thing. Before I forget, F7, 8. If you take a look at my flying character, you'll notice something's missing. Right here, the jetpacks are not working properly. I'm going to be reporting that. But it seems with the DirectX 11 update, the thrusters just don't want to fire when you're flying. They're like deactivated. Which reminds me, you're not stuck going just to DirectX 11. You can go into your options, under graphics, and up here you see the pull down tab. You can go to DirectX 9, right back to where how it was set before. But to do so, you get this message right here. So, if you want to switch between the two, you have to restart your game. Not just the world, the game. Because you can see, even though I switched over, they're there. So next time I log in to the game, these will be back to the old models. Though, I won't be doing that. Also, you'll be seeing from my end the new setups on Space Engineers. Well, Chad won't be because apparently his system won't be able to handle DirectX 11. Sadly. But anyway, I thank you all for watching, and I'll see you next time. Bye!